This song for you in the coffee shop. You know the one right down the block, the one where we like to shop.
I'm a very creative person. I like to create things, whether that's moments with people or music or just moments for myself. I feel like the main thing is just what you believe that you yourself can do. What you expect when people look at you. Sometimes you may act accordingly to what they expect, but I feel like if you act according to what you want to do, if you say that you want to go to the gym, then just go to the gym. It's about taking that first step.
One where we like to shop, but with it started in my bedroom, then it went down to my bathroom.
Sometimes we overcomplicate things by thinking, how am I going to be able to go to the gym for a whole year? Don't think about the whole year, just think about that one day. Try saying, how will I go to the gym for this day or this week? And then at least when I feel like I can't do something, it's because I'm wondering how I'm going to be able to maintain it even before I start. So it's just about starting it, and then you'll figure out from there where to go by just taking one step at a time. I don't really remember having any moment where the doctor came and said, oh, Agasha, you're never going to walk again or run again or do any of the things that you used to do. The fact that I couldn't go to the bathroom by myself, I couldn't sit up by myself, someone had to get me everything that I needed, I couldn't just get something I wanted to eat by myself, just made me feel a little bit helpless. But at the same time, I didn't want to accept my situation. So I was just like, okay, if I don't accept it, then maybe it won't be reality. I was not confident at all. When I'd be in a crowd of people, I'd want to be at the back. I didn't want anybody to look at me. If anyone would ask what was wrong with me, I'd feel very hurt. I'd be like, I'd just not want to even answer them. I'd act like I didn't hear. And I was just feeling a bit helpless at this point because I couldn't do things that I wanted to do. I was a very independent child before. I didn't like anybody to show me that kind of attention when I wasn't well. Like, I also wanted to enjoy life the way I would have enjoyed it before. I enjoyed singing before my injury, so I was like, why can't I carry on doing that?
Hi, everyone!
I was more determined to let people see a different side of me and not just the chair. So that's why I tried to sing, that's why I tried to really achieve the best grades that I could achieve, so that when people see me, they see more than just a girl in a chair. They see other things that I am good at. I got a spinal cord injury due to a tumor that I didn't know about. It just occurred. It happened on March 30th, 2012. I was going to school at Rainbow International School. The day it happened was a very normal day. It was the last day of school. I was really excited to just go and be with my friends. It was a half day. I was a captain with somebody else to organize our team for games. And as the day went on and there were announcements, I felt that something wasn't right with my legs. It was feeling like there were pins and needles in my legs, so I wasn't quite sure what was going on. But I also didn't want to go to the nurse because I didn't feel like she was going to do anything. I just thought I'd wait till the end of the day and sort it out with my mom or any doctor. But as time went on, my gut told me that something wasn't right, so I eventually went with two other students to the nurse's office. While I was there, the nurse didn't really know what to do. She didn't know what was really going on, but she did her best to just relax my legs the best way she knew how. At this point, I was sitting down, and she said, well, if you feel like you're fine, you can go back and then maybe come back if you're feeling worse, or just tell your parents when you get back home. So I remember getting up from her chair and taking like a few steps and then all of a sudden just feeling like I couldn't hold myself up and I had to just like cling onto anything. So I clinged onto the wall. And at this point she was like, okay, you can't go anywhere seeing that you can't even hold yourself up. But I didn't want to stay. I don't remember the details after that, but I just know I ended up with one of my friends who helped me get dressed out of the PE clothes that I was wearing. And then I ended up with my other friends and we were just talking, and I was still a bit uncomfortable with the fact that I wasn't sure what was going on. So I went back to the nurse and she eventually called my mom, who came. She has a medical background, so when she came, she just took like a few looks at me and tested some stuff. And she just, in that moment, I knew that something was wrong, because she just, she wasn't telling me anything, but she just said, we need to go to Mulago Hospital. So we got in the car and we went there. And it turned out that the scanning device we needed to do an MRI was not available at that hospital. So we had to go to a different one. So this whole time I didn't know what was going on. They weren't telling me anything. Even the fact that I needed scans, this was told to me after everything was pretty much resolved. Eventually they did all the scans and we came back home. As I was sitting in our living room, I just hear my parents planning flights to go to Nairobi and all that. And I was still like, and at this point I was like, okay, maybe this is more serious than it actually is. But we just ended up in Nairobi Hospital. And the next day, I think when I got there, they did the surgery that they needed to do. I just remember after the operation, just not being able to move my feet, not being able to do anything for myself. I couldn't even sit up. I couldn't go to the bathroom by myself. It just happened very fast. So a few days later, I got transferred to South Africa to do rehabilitation. And when I got there, I think it was the moment when I really realized that my life was going to not necessarily be the same as it was before. Because I just remember my physiotherapist telling me that, well, now that you're here, we're going to teach you to do things differently than you've done it before. And I was like, this is a bigger deal than I really thought it was. So they taught me how to dress myself. They taught me how to get in the car. They taught me how to use the bathroom. They taught me simple things that I never thought that I would have to be taught again at that grown age. I was 12 years old. So after being in rehabilitation for about 2 months, I came back home where I stayed briefly. And then I went to do another two operations in China and then in Canada, Toronto, Canada. But when I came back, I didn't want to leave the house. I didn't want to go anywhere that required anyone to look at me. So I would only want to stay at home. At home, I felt like myself because my family knew me. I didn't want anyone that knew me before to see me, because I just felt kind of embarrassed, like now needing help to go everywhere that I want to go. That was not something that I liked. I really hated attention, and especially that kind of attention. I didn't like it. But it came to a point where my parents just told me that I had to go back to school. And I didn't want to go back to school. I didn't see what the point was anymore. Like, I pretty much in my mind felt like I'd lost everything. Like, there was no point in learning or doing anything anymore. And also, I wasn't able to go back to my original school, Rainbow, because their facilities were not able to facilitate me. There were very many stairs, and if I was to go back, I would only be able to be in one room, which would limit any interaction with anyone else. And they also were not willing to change anything at that time to make it more accommodating for me. So it became clear that we had to look for somewhere else to go. I went to Heritage International School, which was very accommodating in terms of like access, and the teachers were very open to having me in their class and open to seeing what they could do to make sure that I had the same like opportunities as every other student. But as the years went on and I got to know more people in my class, they really just made me feel more comfortable with them. And as a result of feeling comfortable, I felt like I could do more. I felt like I could express myself more. when we also did like our school trip, my friends would be the one to like say, oh, let me carry you here, let's make sure that this place is accessible. So I had really learned that expressing yourself and just letting people around you know your situation and what you need and how they can help you is much easier than just keeping to yourself, which is the mentality that I came with to Heritage. By the time I graduated, I was very proud of myself because I didn't feel like I was going to do well in school when I first came. And in fact, I didn't really pay attention in class. I would just do the tests for the sake of doing them, but I didn't really do them well. And by the time I graduated, I was able to have strong enough grades that I didn't really expect that I would have when I first came in.
Oh yeah!
In my first year at university, I was able to partake in their talent show, and I won first place with writing a original song and playing guitar. So that for me was very important for me because it was the first time performing in front of people I haven't performed in front of before. And I was also able to end up on the dean's list due to my grades that I attained, so they were really good grades. So, and in terms of physical achievements, before I was never really able to crawl, but right now I'm able to do a little bit more things with my lower limbs. More recently, I do some weights. I lift weights to be able to maintain my upper body strength, and then I also work on doing stretches to make sure that my joints are flexible and there's nothing that is stiff. I do some lower like limb exercises, like I do kneeling. I do stuff that allows some weight bearing on my legs. And I have a standing frame that I used to use, but currently I don't have it right now because when I was at university I wasn't able to take it. But also sometimes being able to stand up and putting weights on my legs is something that I do. But overall, like, exercising has given me like more confidence because I'm able to realize that I can do more things than I actually imagined I could do just by trying. Like, there was a time I was like, oh, I want to crawl but I don't think I can do it, but then I tried. And although it was different than when I would do it before, as an able person, I'm able to try doing it now. And it gives me like more confidence to want to try and like just drive to try and do it again.
Go! Go, Agasha, go! Go, go, go!
Best advice of someone in my position is to just do something that you love doing. If that is like making music like me, then go and make music. If it's a certain sport, there's so many sports that people without able bodies can do. And there's wheelchair basketball, there's so many things. And even if it's not a mobility challenge, if it's any other challenge, just find something that you love doing. When you love doing something, ultimately you will deal with any challenge or any difficulty to be able to carry on doing that thing. And it also just allows you to focus on something else. It's so easy to focus on stuff that you've lost or stuff that is difficult, but if you focus on something that you love, it gives you that distraction and ultimately gives you the opportunity to just better yourself. And when you feel better about yourself, then you're ultimately able to accomplish more and even help others. So that is something that I would suggest someone does to stand out or to overcome feeling like they can't do anything for themselves. The final message that I'd love somebody to leave here with is that your circumstance does not define what you can do and where you want to be. It's so easy to just see what you have lost or what you don't have, but as soon as you take hold of what your goals are and how important they are to you, then it will be easier for you to move past the challenges and move past the doubts in your mind, move past the loud voices telling you that you can't do it, and to just go for that. And once you reach that goal, you make a new one, because you have to just tell yourself that I can't stop and I won't stop and I will carry on until I reach my goal and I reach my next one, and until I'm the person that I want to be despite of any challenge or any situation that you may be in.